Welcome to St. Luke's Chapel. Thank you for being here and for tuning in today. We pray for the repose of the souls of those who have died in the hope of the resurrection. Terry Anderson.
Thank you. Those who are in chapel with us are certainly invited to receive the sacraments. Those at home may want to grab a glass of juice or a glass of wine and some bread or some crackers and share in the sacraments with us. God's love is universal and is everywhere. So let us pray. Oh God, we come to you in this hour of worship to give thanks for all that you have given us as we seek forgiveness for any wrongdoing that we may have done. We ask that you guide us, guard us, and protect us with your might as we offer ourselves to your service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today we remember the sick and the suffering and the people who have died. We pray especially for Terry Anderson, who was a man in Kander who had fought cancer for many years, and his wife died 21 years ago of brain cancer. And so his adult life was pretty much riddled with cancer, so he's at rest. So our prayers are with Terry and his family. As Gail said, we're going to start having dinner after church the second Sunday, or the second Saturday of each month, as well as the last Saturday, whether it be the fourth or fifth Saturday, it'll be the last Saturday. The July 8th, I think, is the dinner, and we're going to try to coordinate having sort of an Italian night that night with maybe spaghetti and meatballs and lasagna or something of that nature, and tossed salad and garlic bread. So anyone that can help out with that, let us know. Put on the sign-up sheet. What else? Is there any other announcements? Tomorrow at Speedsville, Mother Pat's churches, St. John's and St. Mark's, will have at 9 a.m. Mass on the grass in the park in Speedsville. That's always a very nice service. And then at, I think, 11 o'clock, the annual Father's Day chicken barbecue starts. And that's always a wonderful barbecue. So if you can make it, do. It's the chief fundraiser for St. John's. So we would appreciate that. And again, I want to thank you for sharing the service last week with Mother Pat. It was a fun time, wonderful service, and we all had a good time. So. Other announcements, David? Anything going on that we need to know about? David had a recital last Sunday in Endicott, and I heard it was excellent and wonderful. So, anything else anyone wants to add or subtract? Tomorrow's Father's Day. And we honor Father's Day in remembrance of all those who have been in the role of father. And although I didn't have a wonderful relationship with my father, he did the best he could as a father. Coming into fatherhood 3 years after he got back from World War II. But I was thinking, what was the first memory I had that I can remember of my father? And some of you here are old enough to remember Hurricane Hazel in 1954. And my father gathered us four kids and my mother into this tiny bedroom, put heavy blankets over the windows, and we sat, I think a couple of us sat on the top bunk and three or four on the bottom bunk, and listened to the wind blow. But there was a comfort in knowing that our father was there, because we knew that he would protect us, because it was obvious he was doing everything he could to protect us. And I can remember the feeling of, I wish I could be as strong as that man is. And each of you will have your own memory of your father. Each of you will have wonderful memories, and some of you will have not so good memories. I remember he wore a wide black belt, and it was often not on his pants, it was often in my mother's hands. Corporal punishment. And I always thought I should hide that, but then he'd probably lose his pants, so I better not hide it, I'd get in trouble. But with our father, he comes with a wonderful sense of strength. But we also could see weaknesses. But he left us gifts. He left us all a gift of honesty. He left us all a gift of a quick wit, a dry sense of humor. And as we look at our fathers, and you look at your fathers, you will see a legacy within yourself that comes from your father or the person who is in your role of fatherhood. And we have to reflect on our Father which is in heaven. And I think that the role of fatherhood in humanity is based on the role of fatherhood of our Father, God the Father in heaven. He will protect us. He will be a strength in times of weakness. He will embrace us in our sorrow. He'll be with us in our joys. So the role of fatherhood is carried down through humanity from God the Father into the human beings that represent the role of fatherhood. As we continue our journey, I always tell everyone I'm going to mow my lawn tomorrow, so I'm not near the phone in case somebody calls and says, "Hello, Dad." And that's just a joke. That won't happen. But yeah, I have tried in many, many times to be in a role of fatherhood. And I think that's one of the things that a calling of a priest or a minister has, is to be the father to the parish, the father to the parish family, the person who represents Christ, the person that represents God because Christ represented God. And so we come down from the Father in heaven to the Son on earth, to the Holy Spirit, to our fathers. And tomorrow we pay homage to our fathers. I always wondered why so many fathers, when our mothers say, "You did wrong, go to your father." And when we get to our father, they say, "I don't know, go to your mother." And somehow the mother always got the role of punisher. And the father wouldn't do that. I have a friend who's a wonderful father. And he has three children. And three wild children. They're all in their teens and they're devilish. And his wife worries so much about them. And he tries to tell her, "They're adolescent boys. It's a temporary disease. It won't last long. You'll endure. You'll last." And he tries to explain to his sons what is wrong with what you did. And isn't that what our Father in heaven communes to us? Tries to show us through Christ, and tries to show us through life what is wrong with what you have done. What is wrong with what you have done? And he tries to show us that so that we'll gain a spiritual strength from that and not become repetitive in our erratic behavior. And the wonderful part of it is that our Father in heaven embraces us with his love. And our human father may not show it outwardly, but embraces us with his love because he knows we are part of him. I've had to pray a lot in my relationship with my father, but I've come to understand a lot of things. He'd been through a vicious war, lost a brother, lost his father during that war. He had four children when he was in his 40s, a set of twins on top of that. One was pretty much an angel, and one wasn't. I'll let you decide when you meet my sister. And he never could openly say how proud he was of us. But since his death, I've had more people say, "Oh, your father talked about you all the time and how smart he thought you were and how proud he was." And there's times I wish I could have heard that. but it was delayed. I did hear it. And doesn't our Father in heaven do the same thing? Doesn't he show us how proud he is of us, of our accomplishments? Doesn't he show us how we shouldn't judge ourselves as a father image? That we should let the proof be in the children that we're father to and be proud of them? I know that as I pray to our Father in heaven, the one part of the Lord's Prayer that I've learned to accept is, "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven." And sometimes that becomes difficult for me because I want my will to be done on earth as it is in heaven. And my Father is there, my Father in heaven is there to say, that's not the way it's going to be. It's got to be the way it will be so that we can perpetuate creation, that we can perpetuate humanity. I'm seeing a lot of things in our world where we need our Father in heaven. We need our Father for discipline. We need our Father for an understanding. We need our Father to know that we should embrace all people. We need our Father to know that we need to follow Christ as Christians and not follow some other person, because Christ is our Savior and we need to follow Christ as our Savior. Our world is getting difficult. Very difficult. And I'm seeing more and more judgmental attitudes. I'm seeing more and more of prejudices and bigotry. And yet people doing that want to call themselves Christians. I think we need a refresher course about Christ and his life. In the face of all adversity, he would go into prayer and say, "Father, I need your help." And I think in each of our lives, at some time or another, we've reached to that Father in heaven for help, and will continue to do so. And our own fathers have been there at times we needed them. So let us all continue to pray that there will be a sense of strength of spirit represented by our Father in heaven, by our earthly fathers, and by those that played the role of Father in our lives. Because once we come to an understanding of that, we will find love for ourselves, and we will find love for others, and we will have a more peaceful world. So let us all go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us say together the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." Those who would like to make a donation, the alms basin is in the back of the church. You can do that on your way out. Thank you.
Mark for Joy Hymns, number 366.
Jesus Christ, as we ask God's blessing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us prepare ourselves to receive the sacrament of this Holy Communion as we pray for all of Christ's church and the world. You may sit or kneel. God, we come before your altar this day, asking for forgiveness for any sins or offenses that we have done against you, our God, against your creation, against our neighbors, or against ourselves. We ask forgiveness for these our sins. We give thanks for all that you have given us, for our family and our friends, for our church and our parish family, for our community, the state, the nation, and the world in which we live. Help us to preserve your creation for the generations yet to come, that they too may be partakers of your kingdom here on earth as in heaven. We pray for all people who cannot be with us, especially for the sick and the suffering, and for all people for whom our prayers are now desired. We pray for the people of the Ukraine, that war can come to an end, that they may once again discover that they are a free people living in the democracy they choose. We pray for the people in the South who have suffered again with terrible weather. We pray for those who have died, those who have been injured, and those who have lost everything. We trust through faith that you will touch all people with your healing power. We pray this day for all those who have died in the hope of the resurrection. We pray especially for your servant, Terry Anderson. We trust through faith that you have opened your arms in love and mercy and have received him into your heavenly kingdom. Be with his family and friends as they mourn their loss, and their empty hearts may be filled with the consolation of your love and the joyful memories they have shared throughout the years. And now, together, let us confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in our thoughts, in our words, and in our deeds, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We seek forgiveness for these our sins, and our heart is sorry for these our wrongdoings. Have mercy on us and forgive us our sins, so that we may return to your path and walk in your ways all our days. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
In chapel, let us nod peace to one another. At home, embrace those you love with your peace. Among his friends, and he said, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood, of the new and everlasting covenant which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, Lord, we present ourselves, our souls and bodies in reasonable hope to life everlasting, trusting through our faith and our love of you that you shall always be with us, that we can never be alone. Strengthen us with your good spirit that we may come to know your love for us, following the example that you have given us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us all to pray. Gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Those who would like to share in the sacraments, if you would come forward. Thank you.
body of Christ, the bread. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread.
Continue to share your spirit with the gifts you have given us, and in the world in which we live, help us to reach out to those less fortunate than ourselves. We ask all this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may he be with us this day and remain with us always. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Our closing hymn is number 316, with the verses 1, 2, and 3.